Sides of the poles will also flip around, indicating that our magnetic field has flipped directions.
Alhamdulillah, ada Akmal, ada Gilang, ya.
Now, the problem with our electromagnets here is that a small electromagnet like this one would only produce a very weak magnetic field. So you need to know the four ways that we can increase an electromagnet strength. The most obvious way is just to increase the current that flows through the solenoid. Second, we can increase the number of turns in our coil while keeping the length of the solenoid the same. And similarly, we can decrease the length of the coil while keeping the number of turns the same. Basically, solenoids that have very densely packed coils will be the strongest. The last thing we can do is add an iron core to the inside of our solenoid. As iron is a soft magnetic material, it will become an induced magnet when the solenoid is switched on, which will massively increase the strength of the electromagnet's magnetic field. But importantly, it will also lose its magnetic field as soon as the current is turned off. Anyway, that's all for today. So, hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.
Let's switch it on. Let's see what it does.
Through this coil of thick wire, we're about to pass.
In today's video, we're going to look at electromagnetism.
If you look around your house, you will see many devices that have electric motors, such as kids' toys, table fans, toothbrushes, hair dryers, and this electric cutting knife. But how does the electric motor work? You turn it on and somehow it starts rotating. Why is that? In this video, we'll cover the basics of electricity and magnets, and then put it all together to understand how the motor works.
Which we can represent with field lights.
Light bulb. Electricity flows through the circuit, but as soon as there is a break in the wire, the electricity stops flowing and the light bulb goes off. The path must be complete for the circuit to work. This is best done through the use of a switch. Electricity is flowing down the wire. This is called conventional flow. If we take the battery out and flip it, then the current will flow the other way. The light bulb will still work in either case, but there are some devices that will work differently depending on which way the current flows. Okay, so that's the basics of a circuit. Now let's come over here. This is a magnet. It has a north pole and a south pole, and it likes to attract other metal objects like these paper clips. If you bring another magnet towards it, opposite poles attract, and the same poles repel. Magnets don't have to be in this shape. For example, some magnets might be more flat, like this. You can think of this magnet as always on, it's always working, you can't really turn it off. That's why it's sometimes called a permanent magnet. It's made up of many smaller magnetic domains that are lined up in the same direction. But later, I'll show you a type of magnet where this is not always the case. Let's take one of our permanent magnets and drill a hole in the center and put it on something that will allow it to spin. Now bring another magnet towards it. Our spinning magnet will immediately line up until opposite poles are right next to each other. Now switch out the side magnet. The same poles repel and opposite poles attract. If we keep switching out these side magnets, then our spinning magnet will just keep spinning. This concept of the spinning magnet is really important. We'll come back to it several times and then create a circuit.
Which, if we looked at it from above, would look like this. If we now add a lot more turns to our coil, all next to each other in one long piece of wire, we make something called a solenoid. And importantly, the magnetic field within a solenoid is strong and uniform.
The current through the wires forces the magnetic domains to line up. That means we've just made a magnet, or more specifically, an electromagnet. It can do the same things that a permanent magnet can. It can pick up pieces of metal, and it has a north and a south pole which will attract or repel other magnets. But the electromagnet is special, in the sense that it can be turned on or off, just like the light bulb. You can't do that with a permanent magnet. Now watch what happens when we flip the battery. The electric current was flowing this way, but now it flows the other way. This will cause the poles on our magnet to switch places. North will become south, and south will become north. This is called reversing the polarity of an electromagnet. Instead of flipping the battery, an easier way to do this is to just switch the wires. magnet turns on and it lines up with the side magnet. Now, in reality, connect an opposite electric pole pointing up. Now the armature will spin until opposite poles are lined up. We can keep it spinning by switching the wires just like we did before. But this is a lot of work to sit here and manually switch these wires. We need to add something to the armature called a commutator. It's a ring with gaps on the opposite sides. The commutator will spin along with the armature. Now we connect the battery, no more electromagnet, and the spinning stops. Now so far we've only used one loop on the armature. This will cause our motor to have an irregular speed, and in fact, we could get stuck in this position with the brushes halfway between the commutator segments. What we can do is split the commutator ring and then add another loop. So first, the brushes are in contact with these two commutator segments, which turns on this electromagnet, which causes it to start spinning. Once we get to here, the brushes switch being an electromagnet. Some electric there are some things we can do to improve the torque of the motor. Electromagnets are stronger when there are more wires. This is true when we wrap more wires around the metal bolt just wrapped around. Armature in the middle is motor. If you have a device that moves and is powered by your room, the spinning of the motor can be converted to other types of movement, such as the side-to-side motion that we see in this fan.
Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next
time. Or how about this electric cutting knife? Each blade is going back and forth. It all starts with the spinning of the motor to turn a gear, which then pushes these two pieces back and forth.
We're going to look at electromagnetism.
So hopefully this video has made a few light bulbs go off in your brain. If you like learning new things, head on over to Brilliant. This is a problem-solving website and app that focuses specifically on math and science. The idea here is that you learn by doing. Pick a topic, it starts with the basics, but gradually it gets more complex as you go. For me, I've enjoyed how you can see these concepts visually, like the area of a circle. You get to see why the equation works. The best way to learn is to do it yourself. Master the concepts by solving fun and interactive problems. And look at that, they've even got a course on electricity and magnetism. You can learn more about the spontaneous flow. Okay, so that other magnet line side magnetic domain an electromagnet. It can do the same things that a permanent magnet can. It can pick up pieces of metal, and it has a north and a south pole which will attract or repel other magnets. But the electromagnet is special in the sense that it can be turned on or off, just like the light bulb. You can't do that with a permanent magnet. Now watch what happens when we flip the battery. The electric current was flowing this way, but now it flows the other way. This will cause the poles on our magnet to switch places. North will become south, and south will become north. This is called reversing the polarity of an electromagnet. Instead of flipping the battery, an easier way to do this is to just switch the wires. You should be aware that the electromagnet will get very hot if it's on for a while. Just a caution in case this video inspires any science projects. Let's come back to our spinning magnet. This time, we'll replace the spinning magnet with our electromagnet. As soon as we connect the wires, the magnet turns on and it lines up with the side magnet. Now, in reality, connecting these wires would prevent the bolt from spinning freely. But what's important here is the concept of the spinning electromagnet. Now let's switch the wires to reverse the poles on the electromagnet. The same poles repel and opposite poles attract. Now reverse the polarity again. Same poles repel and opposite poles attract. If we keep switching the polarity, our electromagnet will just keep spinning. To make this stronger, let's bring in another permanent magnet on the side. Notice how this side has the south pole towards the center, and this side has the north pole towards the center. The side magnets work together.
If we now add lots more turns to our coil, all next to each other in one long piece of wire, we make something called a solenoid. And importantly, the magnetic field within a solenoid is strong and uniform. Outside the coil, the field is just like the one we'd find.
Nah, ya. Berikutnya adalah.
In today's video, we're going to look at electromagnetism, which is the phenomenon whereby electric currents produce their own magnetic fields. And we'll see how this works in ordinary wires, coils, solenoids, and electromagnets.
Ada sisi lainnya.
Let's start by imagining that we have a wire, and that we let current flow through it, from bottom to top. This electric current would produce its own magnetic field all around the wire, which we can represent with field lines.
In this case,
the field lines would be concentric circles around the wire, and they'd be closest together near to the wire,
as that's where the magnetic field is strongest. Ya, nah,
the direction
kalau arusnya
of the magnetic
ke atas,
field,
berarti dia
is going to depend on the direction
ya,
of the current.
Seperti
so
ini,
to help
ya,
us remember which way it goes,
gerakan,
we can use something called the right hand
rule. Ya, right hand
if you take your right hand,
ya,
curl it into
kanan.
A fist, nah. And point your thumb in the direction
baik,
that the current's flowing,
cepat.
Then the however, if it is now traveling
nah,
in the opposite
dibalik,
direction.
Seperti yang tadi, ya, dibalik-balik,
to make things
apanya,
a bit trickier,
namanya, baterainya
let's now
tadi,
imagine that
ya,
instead
medan
of two separate straight wires, we instead join them together, the current flowing
itu,
in
ya.
Through the bottom left and out baik. Through the right. As the magnetic fields of the two sides of our coil interact, the magnetic fields
nah,
which were concentric circles will now get stretched out and form ellipses.
Berbentuk lingkaran, lintasannya,
and as the magnetic
lingkaran,
fields combine,
nah,
they'll form a single
sana,
magnetic
ya.
Field which runs straight
maka
through the center of the
coil.
Maka
di situ didapati, kita lihat, sebelah kiri, ya, yang sebelah kiri, itu, ya, kan dia ke atas ya, kan dia ke atas. Berarti, apanya, medan magnetnya, arahnya seperti ini, ya. Seperti ini. Nah, ya. Sedangkan yang sebelahnya karena dia lingkaran sampai di sebelahnya ya dia terbalik ke bawah ya berarti ya berarti yang saat ya, berarti mereka beda kutub jadinya kalau seperti ini ya makanya kalau misalkan ada kumparan seperti ini ya ada kumparan ada selenoida dia itu ada kutub utara ada kutub selatan jadinya kenapa karena seperti ini ya ada dua buah sisi, sisi yang ke atas, ada sisi ke bawah, bulat lagi, atas ke bawah, bulat lagi, dan seterusnya. Makanya jadi ada kutub utara dan selatan.
Which if we would look like this,
yeah.
Or turns to solenoid, is strong and okay. Uniform.
Nah,
magnet. Where the field line, the useful field disappears, direction of the magnet, and the sides
nah,
of the poles
okay, kita
will
lihat,
also
ya.
Field electromagnets here.
Nah.
A very increase in electromagnet
nah,
strength.
Empat
the most
cara,
obvious way
ya,
is just to increase the current
ya,
that flows through the solenoid.
Medan magnet. Yang pertama,
second,
adalah
we can increase the number of turns.
Tegangannya, ya, tingkatkan tegangan listriknya, ya, atau naikkan arus listriknya, ya. Maka dengan cara seperti itu, ya, kita bisa mendapatkan medan magnet yang lebih besar. Itu pertama. Ya, tadi ya, seperti yang terkena petir tadi, ya. Nah, listrik yang besar munculkan medan magnet yang besar. Itu poin pertama. Yang kedua, ya, tingkatkan ya jumlah kumparannya, lilitannya dinaikkan, ya. Tadinya seperti ini, agak kurang rapat, yang nomor satu ya. Jadikan seperti nomor dua, lebih rapat, maka akan naik, ya. Nah, medan magnetnya akan naik.
In our coil, while keeping the yeah. Length of the solenoid the same. And similarly, we could decrease
the
length
jadi,
of the coil.
Jadi maksudnya, ya, coba dengan panjang yang sama, lilitannya diperbanyak, ya. Nah, lilitannya diperbanyak, seperti itu. Itu untuk menaikkan medan magnet. Kemudian ketiga, decrease the length, ya, di apa namanya, dikurangi panjangnya, ya, dipendekkan, ya. Yang tadinya
basically,
dia kumparannya segini, pendekkan. Kalau dipendekkan,
dia
semakin besar.
The last
medan
thing
magnet.
We can do. Is add an
yeah.
Iron core
kemudian,
to the inside of our solenoid.
Tambahkan besi,
as
yeah.
Iron
jangan
is a soft magnetic material,
aja, tapi
it will become an induced magnet
dalamnya.
When the solenoid is switched
yeah,
on,
maka itu akan
which will massively increase the strength of the electromagnet's magnetic
medan
field.
Magnet. Okay. Jadi catat ya, ada 4 cara meningkatkan medan magnet. Kalau masuk ujian, berarti jawabannya ini ya. Nah, yang pertama adalah tingkatkan tegangan atau naikkan arus listriknya. Ya. Yang kedua, ya, tambah jumlah lilitan, ya, tambah jumlah lilitan. Yang ketiga, pendekkan, ya, pendekkan, bukan dikurangi lilitannya, ya, cuman dipendekkan, ya, dipendekkan seperti nomor tiga ini, ya, dipendekkan lilitannya. Nah, kemudian yang keempat, tambahkan material, ya, material logam, apakah itu besi, ya, dan lain sebagainya. Nah, itu ya cara untuk meningkatkan medan magnet. Oke, tadi sudah ya video pertama dengan listrik memunculkan magnet. Itu kita manfaatkan untuk sebagai alat pemutar ya. Nah, dinamo ya, generator ya, biasa kita sebut generator ya. Nah, kemudian ya, yang video kedua ini ya, cara untuk meningkatkan medan magnet ya. Untuk meningkatkan medan magnet. Nah, sekarang ini tugas ya. Kita lihat yang ini dulu.
Let's switch it on. Let's see what it does. Nah,
through this coil of thick wire, we're about to pass a huge alternating electric current. On top is a 1 kilogram aluminium plate.
So we hear this noise. What's that noise?
It's the vibration of the plate because it's vibrating at 2 times the frequency of the set of the
Whoa!
How does it do that?
To find out, I've come to the place where it all started, the Royal Institution in London.
This is the key to Faraday's magnetic lab.
Amazing, that lock still works.
From the 1870s, ours became a storeroom, which is why it survived, and it survived intact, all the joinery, drive electromagnet, exactly the same as Faraday left it.
The magnetic field could generate electric current. Faraday answered this question with his most famous apparatus,
which is this.
In August 1831, Faraday wrapped 2 coils of insulated wire around this iron ring.
But in 1831, you could not go down to your local electrical hardware shop and ask for extra meters of insulated wire. You had to insulate the wire as you went. And so as you pushed and pulled the wire out of the ring, you had to insulate it. It takes 10 working days, which is a huge investment of time.
But the investment paid off. When Faraday connected a battery to one of the coils, he saw a brief pulse of current in the other coil. And when he disconnected the battery, he saw a pulse of current in the other direction. He realized that current was induced in the second coil only when the magnetic field through it was changing. And if they hadn't been wrapped on the same ring, wrapped on current is induced, and that's due to passing a huge electric current is induced, and that's due to the interaction of their magnetic fields. Which brings us back to this. Through the bottom coil, we are passing a huge electric current, 800 amps, which alternates in direction 900 times per second. This ensures there will always be a changing magnetic field above the coil. Instead of a second coil, we're using the aluminium plate, but the principle is the same. The changing magnetic field induces currents in the plate that create an opposing magnetic field, so it levitates.
How awesome is that?
This current is not only good for levitating the plate, it can also make light bulbs glow.
Thank you. Oh, that is cool.
Ini ada medan magnet di sekitarnya memunculkan arus induksi.
Can I put it there?
Sehingga ada listrik.
And just as current in a toaster element heats it up, the induced current in the plate dissipates its energy as heat.
Kemudian muncul magnet.
Check out how hot this plate is.
Memunculkan
magnet
ini juga memunculkan listrik yang baru.
Is this your favorite demo?
Like a flying barbecue.
Sehingga bisa menghidupkan.
Tell me this is not the best dinner table centerpiece. It levitates, it gives you light, and you can cook on it. And all the while, you're demonstrating Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction.
But where do they get that matter to grow?
Nah, sekarang ya. Sekarang perhatikan yang ini. Nah, ini adalah tugas ya. Ini adalah tugas.
AA battery and some copper wire.
Tugas yaitu electromagnetism train.
Nah,
yaitu adalah kereta api menggunakan prinsip elektromagnet. Ya, di internet sudah ada ya, seperti maglev ya, magnetic levitation itu bisa dilihat di internet ya. Sekarang ini yang sederhananya. Lihat ya.
So basically we have a AA battery. With a magnet stuck on each current we can play
a AA battery. Nah, lihat
ya.
We use two
bahannya untuk membuat percobaan ini adalah sebuah baterai. Ya. Kemudian dua buah magnet. Satu diletakkan di kutub positif, satu diletakkan di kutub negatif, itu tolak menolak ya. Letakkan satu lagi di sisi satunya.
You can do north out, south out.
Tertutup atas bawah,
basically
ya.
Make sure that the battery wasn't there, you're holding the magnet.
Ya, terhubung dengan arus listrik. Ya, north, yang satu lagi north juga, ya.
Nah,
jadi sama-sama untuk utara, ya. Oke, saling tolak-menolak dia. Sekarang kita lihat dia bergerak dengan sendirinya, ya. Nah, ketika dimasukkan ke coil, ini bukan plastik ya. Nah, ini adalah kawat yang digulung, ya, atau kumparan, sehingga dia bergerak dengan sendirinya, ya. Nah, dia bergerak dengan sendirinya. Kok bisa seperti itu? Coba nanti dicari, ya. Coba nanti dicari. Kenapa, ya, sebuah baterai yang ada muatan listriknya, ya, ketika dihubungkan dengan magnet,
ya,
kemudian dilewatkan di dalam sebuah lilitan. Nah, ini kan lilitan ya, logam. Dia bisa bergerak. Nah, kenapa? Ya, apa yang menyebabkan dia bisa bergerak? Coba cari ya. Cari. Berarti listrik, magnet. Terus ada listrik lagi.
Apa
petunjuknya ya? Tapi intinya gimana? Kok bisa seperti ini ya? Tidak digerakkan, dia bisa bergerak sendiri. Apa yang membuat dia bergerak? Coba nanti diidentifikasi ya. Baik, sampai sini ada yang mau ditanyakan, silakan.
Ever take it off any sweet jumps?
Ya, jawabnya. Ini jangan sendiri-sendiri ya, jawabnya ini aja, diskusi aja. Nah, kalau ada grup ya, nah diskusi aja di situ. Jadi jawaban satu kelas
so boleh, ya, atau buat grup misalnya,
si Fulan sama Fulan misalnya,
and it worked pretty well, but the added weight, gitu. Man,
tapi nggak boleh satu orang ya, harus diskusi. Nah, seperti itu ya. Taip. Sampai sini ada yang mau tanyakan? Nah, iya jawabannya aja. Alasannya kenapa? Ah, jadi pertanyaannya gini. Jelaskanlah ya cara kerja dari ini dari percobaan kereta api elektromagnetik ya, yang ini ya, coba jelaskan cara kerjanya. Terus pertanyaan kedua, apabila tidak menggunakan baterai apakah tetap bisa berjalan atau tidak? Nah, ya dua ya pertanyaannya, coba nanti dicari ya. Jadi ya, kira-kira ada yang mau tanyakan? Ya, baterainya dibuka, ya, baterainya dibuka, ganti sama besi biasa, misalnya entah paku, entah besi, ya, bukan baterai, nggak ada listriknya. Kemudian dimasukkan ke dalam coil ini, kira-kira bisa bergerak atau tidak? Nah, nggak, kenapa alasannya? Oh, Masya Allah. Siapa nih? Oh, Gilang ya. Bisa dibuktikan, Gilang? Enggak deh, ya. Tapi clue-nya ada di internet ya, ada di YouTube. Coba nanti cari. Nah, di situ ada. Nah, ada yang diuji dengan menggunakan baterai, ada yang tanpa baterai. Nah, seperti itu. Terus, gimana cara kerjanya? Kok bisa seperti ini? Juga, insya Allah ada. Kalau dicari di internet ya, di YouTube ada, insya Allah. Karena ada dari elektromagnetik. Iya, dia gimana elektromagnetiknya? Gimana? Kok bisa dia bergerak terus, tidak berhenti? Nah, ya, nanti coba dicari. Taip, sampai di sini ada lagi kira-kira yang mau ditanyakan? Ya, dua soal aja. Iya. Nah, ya, cukup ya. Nah, jadi ini dia tugasnya. Coba cari cara kerja dari kereta api elektromagnetik ya. Nah, ini sudah ada ya aplikasinya, teknologinya. Kalau kita lihat di internet tuh, kita buka maglev ya, magnetic levitation, itu pakai magnet ya, pakai magnet. Jadi dia mengambang ya, kereta api itu mengambang sehingga tidak bersentuhan dengan relnya ya. Nah, kita tahu ya, kalau yang membuat kita lambat berjalan itu ketika besarnya gesekan, misalnya ya ban ya, ban motor ya. Nah, beda bahannya, beda juga ya kecepatannya, seperti itu. Kalau misalnya pas kempes ya, besar tekanannya, gesekannya besar sehingga menjadi lambat. Nah, ini dia enggak ada gesekannya ya, karena dia enggak menyentuh relnya ya. Dia mengambang ya. Nah, sehingga dia memiliki kecepatan yang tinggi. Nah, ini jadi ini percobaan sederhananya ya. Nanti bisa dicari gimana sih prinsip kerjanya, kok bisa seperti ini? Iya. Gitu dia. Taip, ya. Ini saja ya yang bisa kita pelajari untuk pertemuan kita hari ini. Ya, coba nanti dicari jawabannya, didiskusikan ya, didiskusikan, kemudian dikirimkan ya. Boleh satu kelas ya, boleh beberapa orang ya. Nah, nanti kalau misalnya beberapa orang ya, tuliskan namanya siapa aja yang di situ. Seperti itu ya. Kereta api listrik, kalau kereta api listrik dia pakai bahan bakar listrik. Nah, dia digerakkan dengan listrik. Nah, kalau ini dia berbahan magnet. Nah, seperti itu. Kira-kira gitu ya, berbahan magnet. Nah, gitu dia. Kalau kereta api listrik lebih mirip sepeda listrik ya. Nah, pakai listrik dia. Nah, kalau ini dia bahannya magnet. Seolah-olah jalan raya itu diubah semua jadi apa ya. Nah, kemudian sepedanya mengambang di atas. Nah, gitu dia. Hampir terjawab ya. Nah, gitu. Iya, mungkin ini saja ya yang bisa kita pelajari untuk pertemuan kali ini. Mudah-mudahan bisa menambah semangat dalam belajar ya, belajar fisika. Nah, tapi mungkin ini saja yang bisa kita pelajari. Kita cukupkan ya. Mohon maaf atas segala kekurangan. Kita akhiri. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.